The proton is an important building block of all matter around us and was long thought to be a fundamental particle. In this video, we will talk about its discovery in the early 20th century. In 1911, Rutherford performed scattering experiments, which led him to the idea that most of the mass inside an atom is concentrated in a tiny region at the center, which was called nucleus. Later, he performed other experiments, which indicated that the hydrogen nucleus, that is, the proton, is also present in other nuclei. In 1919, Rutherford observed that when he shot alpha particles into air, which is basically nitrogen, some hydrogen nuclei were emitted. He thought that the alpha particle knocked out a proton from the nitrogen nucleus, which reduces its atomic number by one, thus turning it into carbon. In 1925, however, after studying additional experiments, he realized that the nitrogen, in fact, absorbs one proton, thus turning it into oxygen. The other two neutrons were absorbed as well, and one single proton flew away. And by the way, this was the first ever reported nuclear reaction. So whether we take 1919 or 1925 as the discovery date of the proton is rather a matter of one's point of view. Rutherford decided to name the newly found particle proton, after the Greek word for first. Nowadays we know many other properties of the proton. It has a charge of plus one elementary charge, it has spin 1/2, therefore it's a fermion, and in the quark model, it's composed of two up quarks and one down quark. It interacts with all four fundamental forces and has a mass of about 938 MeV over c squared. Although we now know the proton for 100 years, there are still some open questions. One of them, which has been solved only recently, is called the proton radius puzzle. Physicists in Germany were investigating so-called muonic hydrogen, that is, hydrogen where the electron is replaced by a muon. According to the standard model of particle physics, the muon should have exactly the same properties as the electron, it's just about 200 times heavier. However, they measured the proton's radius in muonic hydrogen about 4% smaller than when they did experiments with regular hydrogen. That would disagree with the standard model of particle physics. This discrepancy is now apparently solved when a different study in September of 2019 reported the same radius for regular hydrogen as well as muonic hydrogen. Another question which is still open concerns the proton decay. The standard model claims that the proton does not decay. And so far, we haven't seen any protons decay. But the fact that we just haven't seen it yet does not strictly mean that it never happens. But this is a topic for a different video. So that's pretty much it for this time. Thanks for watching.